I'm looking at the news, oh my God, this is bad. Why is he answering the phone? I wanna help, I gotta do something, this is crazy. Show up.
Yep.
That's okay. Alright, and then show up with a plan. I'm here, this is what my skills are, this is how I think I can help. We'll find a place for you, okay? But here's the opportunity that we're gonna talk about as we get further into the presentation. That's that call for action to volunteer, right? What if you already showed up trained? What if you knew what you were doing when you showed up and you didn't have to guess? Would that be valuable to you?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Because you wanna help your community, you see this going on, and you're like, I can't just sit here. I know somebody that went on that fire.
Yep.
The city. This is crazy, I can't sit here. But if you had that training and you knew how to, then that's even more of a contribution. So hold on to that thought and I'll come back to it. Well, when I woke up on Saturday, I looked out my window and I went, that doesn't look good. And this was gonna be a bad day.
Oh, yes.
Because I had a feeling that wasn't gonna be put out with the garden hose. Okay? And I'm waiting. Now, do you know how we get it back, or how we get activated? We have to have an emergency manager, or a sheriff's department, an emergency official, someone calls and says, I've got a fire, and I'm gonna need a shelter because I'm evacuating someone. I can't just show up at an emergency, okay? I actually get asked to respond.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So sometimes you'll see something like this, and I want you to realize that when you have an emergency, there's certain things that have to take place. First is a team size up. Now I'm putting on my emergency manager hat and not my Red Cross hat, but there's a team size up that says, how bad is it? Is it moving?
Mm-hmm.
Where's the wind? Where's the houses? What's my disaster assessment? How bad is it and do I need to evacuate? That takes time. But you, who's sitting here on the news live, is going, where's Red Cross? I can't believe they're out there. What's going on? And that's because it takes some time to make that decision. So they size up the scene, they see what's going on, and they go, yep, the wind's pushing it towards houses. We're going to have to evacuate. Once they make that decision, now there's that conversation saying, hey, Red Cross, we're going to need sheltering. We're evacuating. So hopefully that kind of gets you to think about how all these different pieces fit together. And it does. It takes a whole community. It takes a whole response. One organization definitely can't do it. So what are our successes? Opportunities, risk management, and mitigation. We'll talk about those. Our successes? Our volunteers are amazing. That's the first thing I have to tell you. First of all, American Red Cross is a volunteer-led organization. Okay, let me say that again. It's a volunteer-led organization. So where is, quote-unquote, the authority, the power, the opportunity to make a difference and a contribution? It's not at my level. Okay, I can direct. I'm kind of like the conductor for music. But if there's no one to play the notes, I got no phone. Does that make sense? So we can't be successful without our volunteers. It won't happen. And during this time, opening up 6 shelters in a 2-hour period, that's a lot of people working really hard. And they just popped open. We even saw those words written in the Gazette. They said, shelters popped open. And I went, yes! Because when there's a delay, and everybody's standing in front of the door, and there's nothing happening, that's not a good feeling. Because your psychological contract's already broken. And the last thing I should do is add to it. Right? Could it happen? It could happen. But it didn't in this case. All right? As I said, relationships allowed smooth operations with our partners, and we had a lot of functional success. Now, FNSS stands for Functional and Access Needs. That means that I'm going to introduce myself this gentleman, us.